Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Story Like. I hope you're safe at home. I know. After these several months, I'm finally back with another very interesting story written by Ruskin Bond. So without any further ado, let's start the story. The Cherry Tree. One day, when Rakesh was six, he walked home from the Masuri Bazaar eating cherries. They were a little sweet, a little sour, small, bright red cherries that had come all the way from Kashmir Valley. Here, on the first range of Himalayas where Rakesh lived, there were not many fruit trees. The soil was stony and the dry, cold winds stunted the growth of most plants. But on the more sheltered slopes, there were forests of oak, maple and deodar. Rakesh lived with his grandfather on the outskirts of the town, just where the forest began. His father and mother lived in a small village 50 miles away. There, they grew maize and rice and barley in narrow terraced fields on the slopes of the mountain. But there were no schools in the village. So, as soon as Rakesh was old enough to go to school, his parents sent him to stay with his grandfather in the small town of Masuri. Grandfather was a retired forest ranger. He had a little cottage outside the town. Rakesh was on his way home from the school when he brought the cherries, and by the time he reached the cottage, there were only three left. "Will you have a cherry, Dada?" he asked, as soon as he saw his grandfather in the garden. Cherry and Rakesh promptly ate the other two. He kept the last seed in his mouth for some time, rolling it round and round and round in his tongue until all the tang had gone. Then he placed the seed on the palm of his hand and studied it. "Our cherry tree is lucky, Dada?" asked Rakesh. "Of course, then I'll keep it." "Nothing's lucky if you put it away. If you want luck, you must put the seed to work." "How can I make it work?"
"Plant it."
So Rakesh went to a corner of the garden where the earth was soft and yielding. He didn't have to dig. He pressed the seed into the soil with his thumb and it went right in. Then he had his lunch and ran off to play cricket with his friends and forgot all about the cherry tree. It was then mid-August when the monsoon rains are at their heaviest and plants spring up almost everywhere. From cracks in the walls of the house, from blocked drain pipes, and sometimes from the trunks of trees, and seeds and seedlings need no looking after. When it was winter in the Himalayas, a cold wind blew and snows wailed the deodar trees. All December and January, the garden was dry and bare. The thick monsoon foliage has long since disappeared. In the evenings, Grandfather and Rakesh sat over a charcoal fire and Grandfather told Rakesh stories. Stories about people who had turned into animals and ghosts who lived in trees and beans that jumped and stones that wept. In turn, Rakesh would read him the newspaper. They knew it was spring when the ducks flew north again to Siberia. Early in the morning, when he got up to chop wood and light a fire, Rakesh saw the V-shaped formation of ducks streaming northwards and the calls of the birds carrying clearly on the thin mountain air. One morning in the garden, he bent up to pick what he thought was a small twig and found to his surprise that it was well rooted. He stared at it for a minute and then ran to fetch Grandfather, calling, "Dada, come and look! The cherry tree has come up."
"What cherry tree?" asked Grandfather, who had forgotten about it.
"The seed that we planted last year. Look, it has come up." Rakesh went on his knees and Grandfather bent double and peered down at the tiny tree. It was about 4 inches high.
"Yes, it's a cherry tree, all right," said Grandfather.
"You must water it now and then." Rakesh watered it and circled it with pebbles.
"What are the pebbles for?"
"For privacy," replied Rakesh. "What's going to happen to the cherry tree now?"
Watch my next video and part 2 to know. Subscribe to my channel, like this video if you liked it, and make sure to share it so others get to enjoy the story too. See you next time. Bye.